Hi, this is Greg from Trump Trader. It's October 26th. I just wanted to talk to you guys about minor and major resistance and how to determine profit targets and entry points. So right now we're looking at the Euro USD on the daily charts in MetaTrader. So as you can see, today we've had some pretty major movement. Some of the most major we've had in a month or so, and just try and determine why that happened. So what happens is there's a couple ways we can determine why that happened. So to get a really good view on things, you always want to zoom out into a farther out time frame to figure out what target it could be trying to hit. And right now what you'd do is you'd zoom back and you'd find out the latest resistance for target. So right now what you could do is you could find that these tweezer tops here on the daily could be easily the resistance that it's looking to get to. I mean the support. So what you do is you draw to the peaks of these roughly. So about 48.40, and that looks like that's where about it actually hit today, roughly about that. So what you could do is because it hit that, you can see here it confirmed it here. And this is the 4-hour chart, and this is the price here. And as you can see, it seems like a pretty valid support. So you can actually put in a long there and have your stop loss maybe 20 or 30 below that, and try to get 40 or 60 pips for take profit. And you can move your stop loss along with that, so you don't take any loss at all. But let's figure out why the price actually left. So I'm going to go into the 1 hour. Now what you do is before you do any trades, before this even happened, what you would have done is taken your horizontal lines and you draw your horizontal trend lines. And that's something about like that. And I'll draw the one for the top, and this is going to be where the target wanted to go north. But as you can see, over the past week of last week, the price never really got past this point here. So this became a resistance. So even though it crossed it here, it's a very long wick, and here too, it's always closed below that price. So this is the first clue that we could be going on a downtrend. And that's not necessary, but what you would do is if you put a long in here at 5,000 or 5,005, you just keep your stop loss to 49.80 and don't move it. You just accept the trade. You would have lost it if you took that trade, and that's fine. So you just accept that. But keep in mind though, you always got to be open-minded when you're trading. Don't ever think you know what's going to happen. But the price never got past this, and you can see some major selling here. This is the first clue. And then once the second clue happened, once it broke here, and these bars are just solid, they broke through this trend line without any sort of resistance at all. This is clue number two that the price didn't want to really come back up in here. Sometimes what it likes to do is it likes to break through and then come back up and retrace on that trend line, and you could put a short here. If that's how you trade, then you would have missed out, and that's fine. You just wait for a retrace, and in this case it didn't do that, but maybe next time it would. But it didn't. It just came right straight through there without any sort of repercussions and just headed straight down until it reached that major resistance. So major resistance was 48.40 in this case. Now there's major and minor resistance. The major resistance is usually found in the higher time frames, like 4 hours or more, and this is definitely a major resistance. This 50 here is a major support, or major resistance. This is major support, sorry. So you always got to keep those in mind when you're making your trades, even if you make them on the 1 hour or 15 minute. Always be aware of where the major resistance is at, because if it breaks through these small channels, these small trend lines, that is a possibility to where the price could be headed. So if you put it along here, that would be great. I tried it along today at 4,900. As you can see, it was actually resistance from the congestion here. I got stopped out 20 pips, and then I put another long at 48.40. So I was kind of impatient. I kind of jumped the gun, and I re-entered here at 48.40. So right now I'm in a long. So that's kind of how you determine major and minor support resistance. Like minor, for example, would be would be this. This is a minor, and I gambled on that and I lost, and that's a trade that I have to live with. I moved on, and that's the key as well. So what we're looking at here for the euro, we could look at a possible retracement up until a it's hard to say. Like, it could be going up to hitting 5,000 again, which at what point I would actually sell, or it could be going to 49.40 around there. And how I get that is looking at this resistance here. I can see a resistance right about here, so it'd be 49.75. It could hit this, but you never know for sure, because now we could be in a downtrend. Just move your stop losses up with you so that you don't really get stopped out, and you're always can take profit. Anyways, that's my short lesson on major and minor support on the EUR/USD. Hope you enjoyed it. We'll talk to you later.